What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a real-time rendering using ShapeSpark. Let's get started. If you do not have this software already, then go to shapespark.com and sign up for a free trial. After that, you will be able to download the software here. In this video, I'm going to use their demo model, which you can download for free on the 3D Warehouse. So follow this link here to download it. First, let's open it up in SketchUp and export it to ShapeSpark. You can see that it would not work if the software is not open, so make sure to have it running in the background. The software comes with a demo model, which is the same one that we are going to use. So for the sake of this tutorial, let's ignore that for now. Now that we have ShapeSpark running, let's go back to SketchUp and try to export it again. Here you can name the file. Now it will take a while to export depending how large your model is. After that's done, you can access your model in ShapeSpark. Now click on this to view the model, and you can look around by dragging the mouse button. If you want to know more about navigating it, click this question mark here to see the controls. The basic controls show you how to look around and zoom with the mouse. The advanced section shows you more controls, such as moving up and down with Q and E, and changing between views with the number keys. This window is only for viewing our model, so to edit the model, exit this window and go back to ShapeSpark main window. Then use this edit button to start editing our model. Here it will tell you that the scene is quite basic because we have not baked or rendered it yet. It also gives you a link to a written tutorial here in case you need any help. Before baking the scene, let's preview our model by pressing this button. The goal of the preview is to show you a rough draft of how the scene will look like after baking. So use it to observe lighting in your model. You can always change the light strength and settings and then preview it again. Once you are happy with how your scene looks, click Bake to render your scene. When you bake the model, the scene will look a lot more realistic. Now let's start editing some materials. I'm going to go to this tabletop surface here and click on the Materials tab, then click on the surface that I want to edit. On the right side, I can adjust the roughness. Changing this number will make it reflective, with 1 being non-reflective and 0 being the most reflective. However, you can see that nothing has changed. That is because we need to add a light probe to our model. I'm going to reset the roughness and move back to the middle of the room here and click on this tab and then this plus button to add a light probe. Move back a little and you will see that a light probe has been added to the model. A light probe is a sphere that captures the panorama of its surroundings, which will help generate reflections in the nearby objects. You can adjust the position of the light probe here. It is recommended that it is located in the center of the room. Now let's move back over here and edit this tabletop material again. Change the roughness from 1 to 0 and bam, there you go. It is reflective now. You can do this to all the materials that needs reflectivity. Furthermore, you can change the opacity of a material by clicking this override box and reduce its value to make it more transparent and make it look more like glass. Test out different values for material settings to see what works best for that material. To make a material metallic, increase the metallic value here, but you also need to reduce the roughness here. Furthermore, you can make a material emissive by checking this box and adjust the strength to your liking. There you go, it's starting to look pretty good. Let's take a closer look at the lighting of our scene. This area here is a little dark, so we're going to need to adjust that as well. But first, I'm going to add a light to this lamp here. We can do that within ShapeSpark or do it inside SketchUp. Before we do that, let's save the scene with this button here and close it out. In SketchUp, use this button to add a light in your model. Now you can export the model again, but this time we're going to update the scene. Press OK and let it load. When it's finished, go back to ShapeSpark and edit the model. Let's move to this lamp and now go to the Lights tab. You can see that the new light has been added to the scene. Now before I bake the scene again, I'm going to change the strength of these lights here to brighten up this area. Cool, let's bake the scene again. There we go. You can see that the scene has been updated to have a light in this lamp as well as brighter lights in this area. Now for the next step, let's add some predefined views to the scene. We can do that by using this tab here. Just move to the view that you want and use this button to add a new view. I can also add a top view with this button here and zoom out to add another. But you can see that this view is blocked by the ceiling. To hide the ceiling from this view, you can go over to Objects, select the ceiling. You can also select from this list here. Now go down to Custom High-End Views and add the view for which you want the ceiling to be hidden. In this case, it's View 2. There we go. Now I have two top views and I can rename these accordingly. I can also add an orbit view with this button here, and I can use the previous workflow to hide the ceiling and other things like these lights from my view. There we go. Pretty cool, huh? Once you are happy with your scene, you can upload it to the internet. Before you do that, you can increase the quality of the scene by increasing the samples value here and rebake it. But I'm going to keep mine as it is and upload the scene. Just close out this window, go to ShapeSpark, and click Upload. When that's done, ShapeSpark will provide a link to view your scene that you can use to view online. This means that anyone who has this link will be able to see it too. And that is all for today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think about this software in the comment section below. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.